time to get cooking with Nanny Bubby. Today, she is showing us how to make a delicious beet salad. Welcome back, Nanny Bubby. I cannot wait to hear this. It sounds perfect for the summertime.
Doesn't it really? But I've got to tell you, there's tremendous feedback right now. Anyway, there is, it is very, I'm so sorry. I'm hearing myself come back into my own ears and I'm losing my thoughts, so I apologize. So let me just tell you that I had a beet salad in Laguna Beach and it was absolutely amazing. And I absolutely wanted to do it, but beets seem so daunting to me. They seem like jicama, and it seems like you can actually, like, cutting through the skin or cutting through the meat is very, very difficult. But I found out after the salad, it was so delicious. I really worked hard to figure out a great recipe, and so here it is. So the first thing I want to tell you is to separate your red beets from your golden beets. It's very important. And what I'm going to show you is as you cut it off, it starts bleeding all over everything. So you always want to put a piece of parchment underneath it, and you always want to do your golden beets before your red beets, because if you don't, see what happens, you will get your golden beets pink. So we're going to slice off the ends. We are going to shave off the skin. And one of the most important things to tell you is that if you put the entire bulb into the pot to steam, it will automatically make the outer part of the bulb very, very overdone and the inner part underdone. So you really want to dice it and or slice it before you put it into the steaming pot. And so I'm just going to show you really quickly that we're going to dice it. Whoop, dicing it here, slicing, and then some dicing real fast and into the pot, into the silicone steaming basket. So I'll just take a handful and just show you it goes right in like that. And then each piece will be perfectly, perfectly steamed. So the next step we're going to do is we're going to be making whipped Roquefort. Now, two things about Roquefort. Roquefort comes directly from Roquefort, France. It cannot say Roquefort, just like you can't say Champagne unless it comes from Champagne, France. Also, it is a sheep's cheese. It's not a cow's milk cheese. So if you're allergic to cow's milk, you can eat it, which is great. So we've got room temperature Roquefort into the food processor, about 2 tablespoons of mascarpone cheese. We're going to take a squeeze of lemon juice and a tablespoon of olive oil into the pot. Do you like Roquefort, Mercedes? I'm contemplating all of this.
I love that, and I love that this salad is only 10 ingredients. It sounds so extravagant. And we had the
good for you for counting that up.
Yes, it's beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
I can't wait to try this.
So what you want to do is you want to refrigerate this for about 30 minutes to get a little bit hard, which I've already done, and I'm going to show you how to plate this. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take the arugula. We put a little bit of olive oil and lemon juice onto the arugula already. So we're going to put a mound of it just like that. Now, you can either platter plate this or individual plate it. Last night for my husband's birthday, I individually plated it. And we're going to take a mound of the red first, right? This red will go on the bottom just like this. 10 ingredients, good for you. I never thought to count that, but that was a good call on your part. I love that.
But it's okay. Easy, it's easy.
Yes, and not all food needs to be easy, because sometimes easy isn't as healthy as you would want. So now you put your golden beets right on top. Are you loving that? On top of that, we are going to put pistachio nuts, just like this. You see that? Now, one of the other keys is taking a little bit of French sea salt. Boy, everything is French. I bet even beets would be French, but they're not. I think they're Russian, originated in Russia. A little bit of French sea salt, and now the beet dust. This is the key. A tablespoon of sugar, a teaspoon of beet powder, and it's just this little fairy dust that you sprinkle all over, including on the side of the plate, and then very quickly off with the cheese. A little bit over here, and a little bit over here, which I almost forgot.
Oh,
there we go.
Delicious.
And just a little bit of beet powder on those, because it turns a little bit gray, and the beet powder brings it back to blue. And there you have it. You love that.
Beautiful summer salad. I had no idea that beet powder was a thing. And like we said, 10 ingredients. Nanny Bubby, you always have the best recipes. That looks delicious. You can't be beat.
Thank you so much. You can't be beat.
Check out Nanny Bubby's Kitchen and Garden on social media and online at nannybubby.com. Thank you to Chapman Automotive for sponsoring the segment. Las Vegas Now, we'll be right back.